Shabbat Shalom. Oh, how good and how pleasant it is when brothers dwell together in unity. So we have, today we are doing day 7 of 7, the Shabbat. Shall we read and then get into the word? Heavenly Father, we give you thanks, glory, and honor. Thank you for the opportunity to begin the journey of learning and teaching. Thank you for your Spirit that leads us, guides us, the flow, the blessing that comes together with it. With the honor and glory of your name, in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Reading from Deuteronomy chapter 7. Sorry, Deuteronomy, day 7, Deuteronomy chapter 20, verse 10 to 21, verse 19. When you approach a town to attack it, you shall offer it terms of peace. If it responds peaceably and lets you in, all the people present there shall serve you at forced labor. If it does not surrender to you, but would join battle with you, you shall lay siege to it. When your God Yahweh delivers it into your hand, you shall put all its males to the sword. You may, however, take as your booty the women, the children, the livestock, and everything in the town, all its spoil, and enjoy the use of the spoil of your enemy, which your God Yahweh gives you. Thus you shall deal with all towns that lie very far from you, towns that do not belong to nations here about. The town of the latter peoples, however, which your God Yahweh is giving you as a heritage, shall not let a soul remain alive. No, you must proscribe them, the Hittites and the Amorites, the Canaanites and the Perizzites, the Hivites and the Jebusites, as your God Yahweh has commanded you, lest they lead you into doing all the abhorrent things that they have done for their gods, and you stand guilty before your God Yahweh. When in your war against a city you have to besiege it a long time in order to capture it, you must not destroy its cheese, wielding the axe against them. You may eat of them, but you must not cut them down. Are trees of the field human to withdraw before you into the besieged city? Only trees that you know do not yield food may be destroyed. You may cut them down for constructing siege works against the city that is waging war on you until it has been reduced. Deuteronomy chapter 21 from verse 1 to 9. If in the land that your God Yahweh is assigning you to possess, someone slain is found lying in the open, the identity of the slayer not being known, your elders and magistrates shall go out and measure the distances from the copse to the nearby towns. The elders of the town nearest to the copse shall then take a heifer which has never been worked, which has never pulled a yoke. And the elder of that town shall bring the heifer down to an overflowing wadi, which is not tilled or sown. There in the wadi they shall break the heifer's neck. The priests, sons of Levi, shall come forward, for your God Yahweh has chosen them for a divine service, and to pronounce blessings in the name of Yahweh, and every lawsuit and case of assault is subject to their ruling. Then all the elders of the town nearest to the corpse shall wash their hands over the heifer whose neck was broken in the wadi. And they shall make this declaration: our hands did not shed this blood, nor did our eyes see it done. Absolve Yahweh, your people Israel, whom you redeemed, and do not let guilt for the blood of the innocent remain among your people Israel. They will be absolved of blood guilt. Thus you will remove from your midst guilt for the blood of the innocent, for you will be doing what is right in the sight of Yahweh. Amen. That is the word of the Lord. Blessed be his holy, his glorious name. So we begin, when you approach a town to attack it, offer terms of peace. Offer terms of peace. So, rules of engagement, these are rules of engagement. When you go to war, especially in the matter of the promised land, okay? If it gives a peaceful response and the town accepts your offer of peace and lets you in, then what happens? Say, forced labor. All the citizens, the town, become forced labor. Yes, imagine labor laws in Israel. There's more spoken about that. If no surrender, if they do not surrender, but rather battle, then lay siege to that town. When your God Yahweh delivers it to you, put all the males to the sword. So if they don't surrender, the thing of then siege, lay siege to the town, and then when your God Yahweh delivers it to you, put all the males to the sword. So it is Yahweh, your God, who delivers your enemies, who are his enemies, into your hands. Okay? Then, very interesting, it's all the males. Now this is something noteworthy, and are being put to the sword. The lesson to be learned with that going forward. However, it says, take as booty. Okay? So this one is kill. All the males are to be put to the sword, okay? But you can take as booty the women and children and livestock. So those are categories, and soon got into trouble with this. And then you can enjoy the spoil. Enjoy the spoil. Whatever else you have in that city or town. So, rules of engagement. Go to a town, go to attack it, offer it terms of peace. If it accepts, go in and make all the citizens forced labor, your slaves. Okay? If not, you siege the city. When finally your God Yahweh delivers the city into your hands, that's the recognition. Then put all the males to the sword. So there's a responsibility in war for all the males. Okay? Here. And that should have an effect also on spiritual warfare. The book of 1 Timothy chapter 2 talks about all men lifting up holy hands in prayer. So, males have a responsibility. When they hand over their city, yes, they are all put to forced labor. When they do not hand over their city, they are all killed, and their women, children, and livestock are taken and the spoils enjoyed by the enemy. It says, deal this way with faraway towns, not neighboring nations. So deal with this way, not the nations that are the land that are being dispossessed from the land that's being given to you. Deal with the nations whose land is not promised to you. Okay? So for the land that is not yours, that's how you deal with them. But for those who are yours, it says, in the towns of the people dispossessed which you are inheriting, leave no one alive. So in the promised land, when you get in, you kill the males, you kill the women, the children, the livestock, leave no one alive. Okay? Proscribe them, and he names them, calls them out by name, the Hittites and the Amorites, the Canaanites and Perizzites, the Hivites and Jebusites, as your God Yahweh has commanded you. Okay? Lest They lead you astray into abhorrent worship, the worship of their gods that Yahweh hates. He hates spiritual, he abhors spiritual idolatry. He hates people who worship other gods. Now we have something to learn. When we have a prayer day that has mixture of gods, Yahweh is not in it. He hates that arrangement. Okay? He is exclusive. He's saying he doesn't mix all the other gods. They are the works of men, but you are the most high God. There is none like you. No mixing, no joint prayer services with any other gods. We worship Yahweh alone. He alone is to be worshipped. No joint prayer services. Now, in case of a long siege of a city, you must not destroy the trees. So now we got the place where. So this is rules of engagement. One. Okay? When you're going to take a city, rules of engagement for cities that accept and those that do not accept terms of peace. Okay? Then several points, rules of engagement, or let's call them slave cities. The other one would say, what kind of cities? All the peaceful cities. And these are for war cities. The Vikings were like that, they are warrior-like people. And in Kenya we also have warrior-like tribes. And the Nilots are warrior-like people. Sai, Samburu, Kalenjin, they are warrior-like people. And our God is likewise a God of war. So there is nothing wrong with war. It's when you meet a warrior-like people as an enemy, that's what you have to do. When you meet a peaceful people, that's what. I come from a peaceful people. We even have a name, and then meaning peace, people of peace. So what happens? And this can play back into colonial times. There were collaborators. Yeah, and then there was the resistance. So we come from the tribes of the collaborators, and they come. The Batu seemed more like collaborators, and the Nano seemed to be resistance. The resistance. The Kikuyu were in the resistance, and so on and so forth. That's the lead you astray. Okay. So that's what we are doing, we are to do. Now for this resistance ones, leave no one alive. The resistance cities, leave no one alive. Why? Yes, they lead you to idolatry. Now in the case of a long siege of a city, you attack. You must not destroy the trees. Oh, the story of the trees. There are trees for food. You may eat them but not cut them down. A tree is human. You have no chance of retreat. Only fruited trees may be destroyed. Cut them for siege works. Okay? Against the city until the city is destroyed. So there are three types of trees in the garden. Okay?
There are others for beauty. There are pleasant lookouts. There are others for food. Remember, the children ones are good at eating. These ones, cut them down. These ones, you know, keep them alive. Just eat the food. And finally, we're going to Deuteronomy chapter 1. And in case of a slain person on the land, the identity of the slayer being unknown. Now that has happened in our land severally. Okay? When we have unknown slayers. Very key implications. Your elders and magistrates shall go out to measure the distances from the corpse to the nearby towns. So, elders and magistrates are required. In our land, in our estate, we have the welfare. So we have a welfare association. And then we have, we'll probably say, government, that should be the MCA, rather the chief and members of government. They shall take a heifer. Now here's an interesting part, the heifer part. It has not been worked or pulled the yoke, so, and what we say, undefiled or unworked. A set apart one, yeah? One that has never worked. Another town bring the heifer to an overflowing wadi, so there's a place, let's say the river bank. We already have a river, Kiu River, so we have the welfare, we have government. Then we go to where the Kiu River overflows. Should find out the other definition of wording. Okay? Which is not tilled or sown and break the heifer's neck. The priest and sons of Levi, the sons of Levi shall come forward. So, here's another group that comes forward. So, clergy. On the cleanses land, clergy should come forward. Yahweh has chosen them to divine for divine service. I was blessed with the name of Yahweh. Okay? So these guys are in charge of blessings and curses. Every lawsuit and case of assault is subject to their ruling. Okay? So we have priests, elders, magistrates. Okay? So they will give a ruling. So they must be present. All the elders from the nearest town shall wash their hands over the heifer whose neck was broken in the wadi. Then there's a hand washing. Now, during the in the temple or in the tabernacle, there's also a hand washing after the offering of sacrifices. So those go together. Okay. After offering the sacrifice, there's a hand washing, and this hand washing over the sacrifice. Then finally, that declaration. That absolves the people. Here's the declaration. Our hands didn't shed this blood, nor did our eyes see it done. Absolve Yahweh, your people Israel redeemed. Do not let the blood guilt remain on Israel. And they will be absolved from guilt. Thus you remove blood guilt of the innocent being done by doing right in Yahweh's sight. So we do these things. So I need to get the elders. Magistrates. So even if it's of this particular property and because the elders they still exist. Okay. I'm an elder, my dad's there, I'm an elder. Okay. And the elders are at 78, and we have other elders, the other brothers, I have two brothers, and about 50, yes, the elders, and we have magistrates, people of government. Okay, that we are concerned for some welfare. So we say the family members, okay, family and anyone else who is in the government and who is associated accordingly, and the priests, and then there needs to be a heifer, the hand washing, there needs to be a cleansing of blood, then finally a declaration. So when we design this, and that's why these ones are there, atonement. Sounds like atonement. Sounds so much like atonement. So looking forward to the Day of Atonement this year. That's looking so much for the day of atonement. Yes, people have been murdered that I know personally and related to in this estate. This process has not happened to my knowledge or to public knowledge. The cases have gone that way, and therefore we are suffering blood guilt because of not handling the cases well. Blood guilt. So I begin to pray that this may be our portion. So there was our engagement. We worked with a peaceful one and slave them. They collaborated and slaved them. If they are warlike and they offer resistance, then kill the men and take the women, children, livestock, and the spoilers as yours. Enjoy everything. That is one. Number two, the trees. When you go to war, trees are not enemies, they can't defend themselves. Eat the food and use the ones for beauty, for work of the war. Men are known slayers. Okay, so the environment is important during war, specifically. Then unknown spare, okay, blood guilt, the issue of blood guilt must be dealt with. I stand here and begin to declare till then a full declaration. Heavenly Father, our hands didn't shed this blood, nor did our eyes see it done. Absolve Yahweh, your people Israel, we your church, your people here of Chaos, God. This particular property, 8th, of the tabernacle of Israel, redeemed. Do not let the blood guilt remain on Israel. Do not let the blood guilt remain on the tabernacle of Israel. And do not let the blood guilt remain in Kahaska. Absolve us from this guilt, in Jesus' name.